An extra town of Lark Hall is perhaps the most staunch Rangers stronghold in central Scotland. Red, white and blue predominate, as do Protestants. Roman Catholics are outnumbered by an estimated 18 to 1. News of Maurice Johnston's arrival at Ibrox was met with predictable shock and some horror around the town's pubs.
I never thought they'd sign a Catholic, especially the one that did sign there. Just unbelievable. Can't even get over it. Maybe wake up in the morning and it will be true.
You take it that seriously?
Aye.
He's a good player, but he's a Catholic. And this town here is Rangers supporter, and he is.
Do you think Rangers supporters will stop going because Maurice Johnston signed and he's a Catholic?
Some might. No, I think Rangers will lose some support through this.
Rangers, their motto stands for Are You Ready? And that's what it's for. It's for blue noses, it's not for Catholics. I don't agree with signing a Catholic. I've nothing against them, by the way, but keep it a blue team and they're going a lot better.
He's a Catholic, and that's it. And this is a Protestant part of the country.
Do you think it's a good thing that he's signed for Rangers?
Good thing for himself, maybe, where finance is concerned. But for Rangers, I don't think so, no.
Johnston. I never ever thought they would have signed a Catholic. But if you're going to say, if you're going to be forced to sign one, you're signing with the best, aren't you? And he is the best.
So you agree with the decision to sign Maurice Johnston, even though he's a Catholic?
I wouldn't say I would agree, no. But if you're going to be made sign of this European thing, it's, you're as well with the best.
I'll be very surprised that the people in Lark Hall will entertain it.
The acid test for the fans from Lark Hall will come when Maurice Johnston finally steps onto the field in a Rangers jersey. Only time will tell if their attitude can be changed.